to the men the fellas stand, and they fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me like a hive of honeybees. Oh, it's in the fire in my
Lyrics Lab, Lyrics Lab. We're back tonight, and this is a special edition. Here we're celebrating the beautiful Miss Esther Rolle. This year would have been 100 years celebrating her legendary, her beautiful existence here on this earth. This is the In the Garden of My Mind edition. I got my guys here, Beto, Mr. Fred. We're just gonna do our thing like we always do at Lyrics Lab. Yeah.
Da 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 da.
It's her duty. Won't you ride by my side night and day? No letting go, no holding back, because you are my lady. And when I'm with you, it's all I got. Girl, I'm so glad we
Can you play it for me a little bit, Beethoven?
Again, tonight is a special edition celebrating Miss Esther Rolle. I actually have to introduce someone I know very well. She's been actually with Cultural Arts Center for about 8 years now, and she does some work out here. She does actual spoken word, and she does a lot in the community, man. And I want to introduce her. A lot of you may know her by Shay, but we call her Eccentric. One more time, come on up, yeah.
Yeah.
You see, she got a little two-step now. Come on. It's so good to see you again.
You too. Oh, I missed it. I guess, you know, COVID.
Right.
I have missed you guys.
Yes,
welcome.
You know, I'm going to let you take this little flow here.
You won't let me get it?
I'm going to mosey on around. All right.
That's cool. Welcome, welcome, everybody out there watching to a very, very special lyrics lab, The Garden of My Mind. If you did not know, Miss Esther Rolle has a poetry album. You can find it on YouTube. Just search Garden of My Mind. So we are paying homage to that album tonight, to 100 years of life, to the iconic, the timeless, the beautiful Miss Esther Rolle. And I'll tell you, the more I get to know her, the more I fall in love. So we're hoping all of our activities this week have caused you to fall in love with Pompano's own. So tonight we have poetry. We have a song tribute. We have Beto and Fred in the back. We have live music, and we are having a good time celebrating life tonight. So thank you for joining in. I hope you enjoy. Until next time, we can commune in person. Enjoy us from your television screens or phones or wherever. Thanks.
Today we speak about gardens, how you take care of it, water it and watch it grow, about gardens being home, and how home is the place where legacies begin, about knowing that home is what makes you safe and afraid all at the same time, when where you're from makes you who you are. Where did you start your garden?
We come from Clarendon. Miepenton, Moko, Ronakaman, gun wars in broad daylight that shelled us in on school days. I'm talking army men. In your backyard, eye contact with loaded barrels, may leave casings laying at your feet. Wrong political party affiliation may bring you closer to God than justice. Weeping mothers crossing over their hearts and sun bodies at once, wearing gunpowder like war paint, fighting for their son's sake, but a prayer can outlast a bullet days. I don't speak much about my heritage because your attention span does not travel beyond vacation destination. So when you ask about my precious Jamaica, understand so in a fashion statement. Out of many, we are still one people. Know that some days we may wake up ugly, but our beauty does not stop on the resort shorelines of Montego Bay. It runs much deeper than that.
Like water in our garden, where's your garden?
I'm from Miami, the southernmost major city in the U.S. Population, 2 million too many to count. Even though we're almost surrounded by water, this heat can make it feel like a drought. My sign is a cancer, which made me another crab in this bucket just trying to get out. And look at me now. I made it somehow, somewhere other than a casket or a cell block. And I didn't have to rob anybody at gunpoint or sell rocks. I used my God-given talents to make a way, but I can't say that I did it on my own. It was Miss Charlotte Seward, my drama teacher, who actually introduced me to Miss Esther Rolle, made school feel like my second home. In fact, I spent more time there than I did at the crib, because who wants to live a life where a kid has to break up fights between his parents? She was my make-believe auntie, the sister I wished my mother had. At times, she played so many supporting roles. She was the leading man when I needed a dad. Outstanding performance, if you ask me. She deserves an Emmy, Grammy, Oscar, and a Tony. How many people can say they met their guardian angel face to face,
or stood with your face to the sun? Where are you planted?
Where I'm from, being human is a sin. I'm supposed to be a machine, sick of going to war with my community, ducking front porch guerrilla warfare. cop car drill sergeants, rest in peace, Greg Frazier. But it ain't all bad. We had some good times thanks to Miss Esther Rolle. History was made politicking with Mr. Carl Reaver. Tiger trails were paved by Miss Ely. Pride being stitched on the seam of my soul. I am made in Pompano, young, black, gifted, my mother's mother providing six branches, family trees being watered by resilience where little girls become trombone players and others are drugged into poetry clubs. RIP, Parkway East, the projects. Live strong, West Side, Sanders, Liberty, Pine Tree, Kendall Green, Golden Acres, all predominantly black, all making up this beautiful city we call Pompano, resting just off of I-95, exit 36, just big enough for us to call home.
A garden.
Jamaica.
Miami.
Pompano.
And this is where I grow the garden of my mind.
The place where legacies live.
And we're back. Now, we are going to present to you a very, very, very special poetry tribute to the birthday girl herself from her Hollywood daughter, Miss Bernadette Stannis. She's going to send us love and poems all the way from California. I hope you guys enjoy. She spent a good time creating this. We had an interview just a few weeks back. If you want to check that out, check out our Facebook pages and see what you missed. Once again, welcome, Miss Bernadette Stannis.
One of a kind, a woman strong and tall with confidence that amazed them all. Who is this proud being who could read right through you? As she throws her head back and laughs, then slowly turns to you and speaks her truth. She was a dancer in her youth. She was born to be a star, not just a star in TV or a renowned person in history. Esther Rolle was born to be a star, born to one of 18 children, to parents who told their story so a little black girl could grow up in her glory. She was a woman who knew who she was, a dignified queen of the Nile. She understood the beauty of being black and the struggle of being strong. When black people told her, "You have no place, you don't belong," Esther Rolle again would laugh and say, "I always have a place. I know where I stand, right next to my Jamaican mom and dad." Her aura was a light of peace, generosity, happiness, and joy. She gave droplets of wisdom to every girl and every boy. Her strength to me was being herself unapologetically. Her charm was simply her calm. When she spoke, all would listen because she was an observer of life. No wasted words and no unnecessary strife. I was blessed to have met such a gem, especially in the times we were in. The first black family show to be seen by the world, where there was a mother, a father, two boys, and a girl. She demanded respect and dignity of that show. And if not, she'd be the first to go. Her fearless, uncompromising, knowledgeable mind created a show that lasted through time. It's still played all over the world. Now, who could have done that but a little black girl who knew who she was and paid them no mind? Esther Rolle was born a star. It just took the world some time to recognize her shine. But whether they did or they didn't, it would have made her no never mind, because Esther Rolle was truly born one of a kind.
One time, give me the snaps. You all know it. Y'all know it. Y'all know it. Tell somebody. Share it. Once you add this and make sure you guys tell somebody to come in. It doesn't matter yet. We're still here. We're vibing. Okay? So next we have a beautiful songbird. Her name is Janelle. I'm going to let her come up here and do her thing. But she's a sweet singing songbird. And I had the privilege of hearing her back in church. Oh my goodness. The soul. Y'all ready? Janelle.
Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute, or built to suit, or fashion model size. But when I try to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. Oh, it's in the reach of my arms, span of my hips, stride in my step, the curl of my lips. I'm a woman, phenomenal woman. Oh yeah, oh I'm a woman, baby. Into a room just as cool as you please. And to the men, the fellas stand and they fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me like a hive of honeybees. Oh, it's in the fire in my eyes, the clink of my step, the joy in my feet. I'm a woman, yeah, phenomenal woman. Oh yeah, oh I'm a woman. woman, woman, baby.
Oh my goodness. One more time, y'all. Janelle, y'all give it up for her. These songbirds, she did her thing. Are you guys still there? Hey. All right, we're moving right along. We have another spoken word poet. She's also working here down in South Florida. We're gonna let her introduce herself. Her name is Sharika Mitchell. One more time, that's Sharika Mitchell.
Someone asked me, what does God sound like? I told them, God sounds like a still room, like 9 months, like birth of a new life, like a soft whisper over a cradle, a sweet melody over a tight beat, like it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. God sounds like Ella, like jazz, even when we're beaten black and bruised backs, bent back, barely breathing. God still sound like the blues, like Harlem, like Mammy, like hums, bongos, the clicking of a railroad track. It sounds like old Negro spirituals, celebration in safe houses. God sounds like Harriet, an underground map to a freedom land where freedom ain't so free. It sounds like 1913 and 2019 with everything in between. It sounds like the beat of women marching because equality and equity still don't sound like the same thing. It sounds like the banging of a glass ceiling. We walk with shards in our knuckles and in between our fists, so keep your glass slipper, a woman not supposed to do no heavy lifting. We belong in the kitchen, in the House, in the Senate, in the Oval Office. God sounds a lot like Shirley on Bost and on Butt. Sometimes God is a slow-moving powerhouse. It sounds like the clipping of Jim Crow wings. It sounds like the unsung heroes we don't know nothing about, like Baker, Clark, Bates, black women being out of this world but stayed behind chalkboards. These figures are still under calculated days. We wake up and don't hear the Messiah within us. Days, little black girls don't hear the black magic pumping through their veins. Here, Khalichi, Christine, Azeed, the 30 under 30, God sounds a lot like you, the beautiful, black, and gifted you.
Lyrics Lab. We're back. We're still here, actually, and I'm having a good time. I hope you guys are. We have some spoken word. He's a writer. He's from Miami. His name is John Kill. I want you guys to give it up. Some snaps, some hearts, but do what you can for Mr. John Kill.
Hey, y'all see that boy, John? Man, that boy is so black that you could only see him at night when he smiled. So I smiled, even during the day, because I didn't want to feel like the invisible man. I was just a boy. I remember picking up the bar of soap, staring in the mirror, and scrubbing so hard that my skin blistered. It's not like I wanted to be white, just light enough to be accepted, so I tried to wash away my insecurities, even if it meant erasing a part of me. While everyone else sees the world as black and white, I was just hoping to find the mocha in the middle. Will I ever feel safe being black? Or will this color act as a bullseye on my back, making me a walking target? I'll never understand why people lay down in caskets called tanning beds, basking in the artificial glow, hoping to emulate the hue that most criticize. In the eyes of the beholder, beauty is only skin deep, but if looks could kill, we all be guilty of genocide. My people are dying. My people are bleaching away their heritage. That which was meant to protect and prevent damage is now damaging us. Our people are dying for vanity. Globally, people of color spend $9 billion per year on skin bleaching products. Whitewashing has never been more profitable. Black woman bleaches her skin to become the next biggest star in Hollywood. Brown woman bleaches her skin to become the next biggest star in Bollywood. From the US to India, how many more layers of the epidermis do we have to peel back before we get to the root of the problem? It's not us, it's them. These corporations are peddling poisons to our people, perpetuating the plight of our pigmentation. Will I ever feel comfortable in my own skin? Because I feel like I've been wearing mine two sizes too small. Now, whenever I feel the need to make alterations, I'm reminded that this birthday suit was custom fitted and tailor-made by him just for me. You know, they tried to tell me my skin was stained. What they didn't know is that black is the most difficult spot to remove. You can't just wipe me away. My skin is more than just a color. It's more like armor shielding me from the hatred that beams down from the lighter hue. My skin is elastic, stretching something from nothing far beyond the reach of my oppressors, along with the ability to bounce back. My skin makes me resilient. My melanin makes me magical. Because who said stars are the only beauty that you see in the dark?
That was amazing. That was amazing. People are doing great things out here. Thank you so much, Mr. John Kell. One time. Give me the snaps. You all know it. Y'all know it. Y'all know it. Tell somebody. Share it. Once you add this and make sure you guys tell somebody to come in. It doesn't matter yet. We're still here. We're vibing. Okay? Baca Lyrics Lab. How's it going? We're still here in the building. And I'm about to introduce the lovely Miss Eccentric. You've seen her just a little while before. She came up here and introduced the others, but she's about to do her thing. You ready? Miss Eccentric.
Everywhere I'm turning, nothing seems complete. I'm standing and I'm searching for the better part of me. I am Superwoman, yes I am. See, I am Superwoman with super issues. And like a psychic ball, it's crystal clear. They are always lingering, are always near, but there is no time to fear because this satin cape places the weight of the world on my shoulders. Following Dorothy down that yellow big road to courage because it makes me bolder so that if I have to carry this boulder alone, I can snap back like a rubber band. Man, mounds of pressure, but here I stand. Combating this sick and bitter democracy, I got imitators, haters, and unbelievers jocking me, wearing my symbol of freedom at Halloween parties, placing them on inanimate objects, and I'm not talking Barbies. It's a shame. I done seen some women do some strange things for a little piece of change, and what a shame, because their kids are starving and brothers ain't in no better, seeking to reap multiple harvests, but he's neglecting the one who holds his heart, and this is where I come in. I'll pull up my tights, lace up my boots, and let my cape blow in the wind, and if Superwoman's cape got too heavy for her shoulders, what would happen then? The world would be in trouble and fall deeper into sin, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. So even though I'm the one fighting, continue to thank the man above, and I'll team up with my Superman, my stud, and come back this world one immoral act at a time, ensuring that no soul is left behind, never late, always on time to keep this world safe. And before it is all said and done, it is the world that I would take everything and replace it with something great. And as far as I am concerned, my shoulders are the only ones strong enough to bear Superwoman's cape.
Sounds so good, sounds so good. Don't you agree? Y'all give it up one more time for the house band Baca Lyrics Lab. That's Beto, that's Mr. Fred. I've enjoyed myself thoroughly tonight. Oh my God, it has been such an amazing time celebrating the lovely, legendary Miss Esther Rolle. Happy birthday to you. It's been 100 years of celebration, living life, doing your thing. We're all here. Thank you guys again for coming out. We're going to vibe how we usually do on our way out, but you guys enjoy yourselves tonight, all right? What's the song? You know the song? You ain't really gotta be my girlfriend. I'm not trying to pressure you. Just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even really gotta be my girlfriend. I just wanna know your name and maybe sometime we can hook up, hang out and chill. I'm not trying to pressure you, just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even really gotta be my girlfriend. I just wanna know your name and maybe sometime we can hook up, hang out and chill. I can do this all night with Beto.
To the men, the fellas stand, and they fall.